what it's won and it's what out because it's out of the nature. I try to understand you.
It's
no?
Just one or
one? One underscore out.
Then to the third
letter. So the folder is Carbone Winter School Simulation Embedded Reservoir Model. Ah, okay, there is a graph. It's this one. So it's one underscore out.
With Carbone Winter N.
If I open Carbone ERM, it will open all the 1 to 7 SIM files.
And one underscore out is not that.
No.
No.
Ah, it's just one.
Okay,
I give you the
No, but that is mine. So yours is
and the others one.
We copied the beginning.
So the first part is always the same. You are defining that we specialized in the creeping, the shortwave radiation, the total shortwave radiation that we simulated using the components, and the air temperature that we specialized using the creeping. Then we have these two components, which are two for the rasters, so we are reading the DEM, the digital elevation model, and the skyview factor, which is required by the snow component, and as usual, the centroid. And then we have the components of the polar rock.
There is a question here, then now later.
So the first component is the rain snow separation component. I didn't show you, but this component is able to separate the rain from the snow depending on the temperature. So there is an algorithm different for the temperature. Then we have the component for the snow, then for the snow canopy, for the snow reservoir. Then we have the root zone component, the canopy component. This component is for the runoff, the groundwater component. And then we have here the masking dam, but actually we don't need because we are here, we don't need this component because we are simulating all just the discharge within the child room. And then there is this component that sums the output from the runoff and the groundwater. And then in this case we have the two writer components, which are the writer for discharge and for the storage. So for example, I'm interested in see how the storage within the root zone is varying in time. But we can write also the storage in the groundwater, we can see discharge from the runoff, we can see the output from the reservoirs. So if we have a look on the parameters, so the reader, you are now you are pro on the reader use more or less. Okay. So the rainfall, the rain snow separation has an input these two parameters, which are two coefficients, which are usually calibrated. If you don't have measurements, again, if you are able to calibrate with against your no measurements, you can disconnect this part, so the rain snow and snow reservoir, and calibrate these parameters. This is the melting temperature. These are the readers I told you before. These are the parameters for the snow model. So you can choose between three different models. In the bibliography, in the references list, I gave you the paper that Giuseppe wrote on this. So you have all the information about all the other models. In this case, we are considering the POP model. And these are the parameters, so the radiation factor, the freezing factor, the alpha, and so on. So again, these are calibration parameters. Then you read the evapotranspiration, the Lippmann index, and here we are with the model. So we have the canopy, where Kc is the coefficient of the reservoir of the canopy, so it's a sort of crop coefficient, and P is the fraction of rain that is passing directly through the canopy without being intercepted. This 0.65 was set, was given by one of your colleagues, Julia, that made the study about this parameter, but we are going to calibrate the K parameter. About the root zone reservoir, so we have the maximum storage within the root zone. The PB soil is the parameter of the Zao equation, so it's this one. Which is basically telling you how in the space is varying the capacity of the root zone. A and B are the coefficient of the nonlinear reservoir, so coefficient and exponent of the nonlinear reservoir. A is the area of your basin, and time step is the time step. So for example, in this case we are working at our time step, so here we define the beginning of the sim file that you are working at the hourly time step, so 60 minutes. Okay, then we have the parameters for the runoff. And again, so we have, okay, this is also interesting. DP853 is the model that we implemented for the resolution of the ordinary differential equation. There is another one, which is the Eulero solver, but you can implement, if you are interested in this mathematical part of the model, you can implement also your own solver of the differential equation model. And so the runoff, so we have again the coefficient of coefficient and exponent. So for example, in this case, we are considering a linear reservoir because we put the exponent equal to 1. And here is the choice of the model. So in this case, we are simulating the case with implemented with the non-linear or linear reservoir. The other type, this one, in which the coefficient is a function of the area and the simplification that we used for the Basilicata case, you have to simply change this with the S. Because it's simplified. modify the embedded reservoir model. Then there is the groundwater reservoir. Again, we have the coefficient and exponent of the linear reservoir, the area, the time step, and the maximum groundwater within the maximum storage within the groundwater. Okay, these are the parameters of the masking dam. So, if you are interested in this is the discharge generated at the islop, then you have to route it to the closure section, so you can use masking dam. And here are the three parameters. So L is the length of your channel, so you can simply compute it through, for example, QGIS. So there is the command to see the length of your channel. And these parameters are the parameters of masking dam equation. The channel celerity and it's a shape parameter that depends on the shape of your channel. And these are also parameters that we are going to calibrate. So as I said, I was interested in see the discharge, so the total discharge, and the storage, so I could just do these two rather. And then let's see the most interesting part of the sim file, which is the connection between the components. So the output of the reader of the precipitation and the temperature are the input for the rain snow separation components. The rain snow separation melting temperature, since it's the same parameter that we are going to use for the snow model, is a parameter that is passing through from the component of the rain snow separation to the snow component. Then we have the output from the rain snow separation component. So every time you see out means that something is going out, of course. When it's in, it's something is coming in. So these are the inputs of the snow component. And every connection is like this. I want to show you, just for example, the connection between the output of the canopy, so it's this one. So for example, the true wall is the input of the zone, in the field which is called the rain. And then, for example, the output from the recharge term of the groundwater is the output of the root zone. And then we have that the output of the runoff reservoir and of the discharge, the groundwater reservoir, are going to be summed by the component that does the sum, and are the input of masking dam. So the sum from the root, the runoff, and the groundwater are the input of masking dam that is propagating on the channel. And then we want to write the output. Is it clear? More or less? Yes? You're lost? No. Yes? No, it's good. Okay. Look at your face. Okay. So